Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, here to the FACEIT studios. I'm Hugo, here with Harry. How are you doing?
I'm doing very, very good, my friend. How are you?
It's been
one hell of a day, to say the least. But yeah, no, we're here. We're in FACEIT. I don't know how that happened. But yeah, it's going to be good, I think.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty cool. Of course, we have a lot of matches for you coming up tonight. This is going to be the ECS Dev League Season 2, of course. And three best of twos. Two of them EU, one of them NA. We're going to be up here till probably 1 in the morning our time. So it's going to be a lot of fun, obviously. But kicking it off with the leaderboard here, we will see the first matchup on the top right is going to be Flipsid3 versus Preparation. The top two teams the fifth and sixth best teams here so far in the league. You can see they've both won 5 and 4 maps respectively. So obviously going to be a lot of fun for the first matchup.
Definitely. I mean, one map between these two guys, as you can see, Preparation, they've gone kind of even across the board 1-1-1. That's a nice little scoreline to be having, I would say. Flipsid3, they're 1-2-2. They're actually in a bit of a streak of losses recently. I believe it's a 5 or 6 streak right now, so it's not looking too good for them. Hopefully they can get out of that rut for tonight's game. That'd be interesting to see. And, of course, they've just picked up a brand new player, haven't they?
They have. As of today, picking up Electronic, of course, in replacement for Shara, which I think, obviously, we're not going to look too deep in analysis because we don't know who's going to be performing well for their side. But, obviously, Shara has been a bit of an underperformer in terms of fragging ability compared to Electronic recently, or obviously in all the teams he's been in. So making this decision of having a roster change may be good for them, but we're going to obviously have to see how it comes out into play. And, of course, as you can see, the schedule for tonight, these are going to be the first two best of twos on your screen, Flipsid3 versus Prep, and then we have Godsent versus Preparation as well. But of course, the first map is going to be DE Overpass here. That is Flipsid3's map pick, and then following up is going to be Cobble joining that. So two obviously interesting maps, nothing too special to note. We will be going to the knife round in just a few seconds, of course, and then the pistol round, as the knife round is actually underway right now. But of course, this is going to be Dev League Season 2. And actually, talking about Preparation, they recently picked up three players as well themselves, changing and have a bit of a roster switch up. We do have, if I'm correct, Ubique, El Patron, and Facecrack recently joining as of 5 days ago. So we've got a lot of new rosters here, and probably a bit of competition, as these teams aren't really going to be fully set up into their new roles, and there's going to be, probably issues. Not issues, but settling. They're going to be settling into their new roles, I think.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, so there's a lot of new blood for both teams to come to the board, and it's going to bring a lot of new interesting scenarios, I feel, actually, just across the table. And while I think with the addition of Electronic on the flip side, it's going to bring a lot of new things. But actually hopping in game now, and here we can see the map. It's going to be Overpass, as we saw earlier. And while Flipsid3, they found themselves on the CT side, the more advantageous out of the two. And while looking at the buys early on, it's going to be Kit's present over on Flipsid3. Armor across the board as well, with the exception of Blade. He's gone for the utility. And Preparation, they've gone very, very ballsy here. Just, all-out armor.
Yeah, very confident play here. And Blade, he's going to be spotting out a few players over towards the B-shot. Straight off the bat, though, Markelov pushing up in towards the monster area, going to get caught out from Facecrack. So Preparation, going to be a man up straight away as we go into this round. Blade getting the information and Markelov playing off it, but it's not going to be working out for them too much. It's Preparation, they will take that man advantage without receiving any damage as well. They can easily rotate back, and you can see they will be doing so. Bomb and three of the players going up towards A here. So we have a bit of potential for an A split. One player down towards B. He can either push in late and catch in these rotating CTs as they push up through connector. And obviously, one more player, he is going to be joining them through connector himself as they start to make this A long push towards the site.
Yep, three players here to try and find something out towards the A site. And while Patron as well making his way in through connector, it's going to be a bit of a problem here. They do leave Arch behind to try and watch things over towards the B site, try to kill those rotators off to hold down the A site. However, it is going to be in the hands of wayLander and WorldEdit trying to hold this one down. 40 seconds left. They've got a good bit of time to try and get out onto the site as the push comes in from long, and it's going to be WorldEdit potentially to try and start things off. Blade in towards B is able to find the one onto the lurker. Now the push is going to be on the way out towards the A site. wayLander trying to do what he can. Picks up one frag, makes it two. Going to be going for the third. He's not able to land that frag just yet, and jmqa trying to trade things back in their favor, but they've still got to test with wayLander. He gets the third as well, but he's finally going to get taken down. And now Facecrack finds himself in a 1v2.
Yeah, it's going to be a difficult one. Probably not too much likelihood, as he's only got 20 HP. Does manage to drop Blade, but Flipsid3, they are going to take it back with a kill onto him. Electronic finishing that round up there for the CT side. And they will take that pistol, but a very, very close round indeed. 3 HP left on him, and he will be able to take that defuse in time as well. So 1-0 to Flipsid3. Preparation getting the bomb down. Most likely going to be going into this eco now before they go into their buy in the third. And Flipsid3, obviously, this is the thing. When you get into the second round after the T's get the bomb plant, you've got to make that decision. Do we want to go for a very SMG-based East buy, or do we want to go for the rifles? Because if they go for the SMGs, likelihood is Preparation aren't going to force. As you can see, as I say, that Caster's Curse, they are. But yep. Likelihood they aren't going to force. And so chances are you'll be bringing these SMGs into the buy round, which could bring a bit of an issue for the CTs, because obviously SMGs aren't going to be as good as the rifles. But Preparation, they're going for the force buy. They've got the Galil 4 Tech 9s, and they're just going to be running up towards the A side. But WorldEdit and wayLander are both going to be picking up kills. Shotgun work from WorldEdit, and wayLander just spraying down two over towards the A side, leaving just jmqa alone as he's off towards Fountain. The bomb's going to be down here for Flipside. They can just hold on to that one, and jmqa, he's going to be taking a bit of long control. But at the end of the day, the bomb's in the hands of Flipside right now, and they've only lost one player, so they're in a really great position to pick up this second round.
Yeah, and as wayLander goes aggressive towards long, could have getting taken down there, but his sixth sense does come on through. He's going to get away. 16 point of health left alive on him. And while jmqa trying to do what he can, 1v4, bomb is down. They've got full control, and they've rotated everyone in to try and deal with this. They have the positional advantage in terms of where jmqa can go. They do have control as well of the connector area. So as he tries to kind of turn back around and retreat back to approach from that angle, might be finding a bit of a firefight here with Markelov, who's playing this position steadfast and firm. Doesn't want to give it up. Doesn't want to give too much in the way of jmqa. 45 seconds left. He's still got a good bit of time to work with, and a lot of utility across the board. Markelov's going to be the one to try and face this out with the MP9. Notoriously the best gun in the game, by the way, Hugo. And, well, jmqa is going to be trying to peek around the corner, finds the shots, but doesn't do enough damage. Markelov there with the headshot. MP9 reigning supreme, and that's going to be the second round on the board for Flipside. Now, what's this going to mean for Preparation is that, as a result of trying to do something a little bit risky with that force, they will now be onto an eco, and they're not going to be able to buy up until that fourth round, unless they opt to force again, which, I mean, Archie's grabbed himself a Tech 9. He's trying to be a crazy player.
Yeah, he's invested a little bit more into this round. None of the Preparation players, apart from him, are going to be buying up, of course, just going for this eco. But the thing is, the loss bonus is not huge here in their favor. They will be able to get a buy up in the upcoming round, but it's not going to be full of utility. They shouldn't have any Molotovs, but we'll still have the smokes and flashes. And again, Preparation, not too much threat here from the Flipside players as they start just to push in towards this A courtyard. You can see the first kill coming out from Blade. We do see a bit of a return from Ubique, though. He's going to be able to drop World Edit, grabbing the Tech 9 off of a fallen teammate and trying to follow up. But the aim punch is going to be too much. Blade able to execute him, and we'll follow up as well. Should be a fairly simple round here for Flipside, but as I say that, jmqa, he's got himself a really good position here. Got to be pushed all in towards the B CT spawn here. And I mean, there's a lot of potential to at least push up in towards CT, take A control, or of course take this one player down, electronic rotating back into the site. And you can see he could potentially go for some kind of knife play here, and it could be pretty hilarious.
Yeah, I mean, they don't know how he's gotten here right now. He's been able to get in behind enemy lines, and our patron's going to be baiting him out as jmqa comes on through. Just take that knife out, grab yourself the extra $1,500 going on through. Here it is. Ring that bell, Hugo, as he finds the knife frag. There we go. Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner. It's going to go 2-1-3, and they should be able to get a plant out of this, providing that Blade doesn't do something huge. He's already got 3 frags to his name. Potential to get the ace here as he finds Patron, who gets that bomb down. Now it's going to go 1-on-3. jmqa once again finds himself in these impossible situations, but this time bomb is planted. So potential for him to be able to create some damage here. He sneaks in behind wayLander. What's going on? He's the ghost right now. He's constantly behind enemy lines, and he's the thorn in their sides. And his position's going to find that first. And a wayLander goes in for the spray, but defuse is going to be coming in. They actually get off of it as he's putting a lot of hurt down onto the site, and they've got to deal with him. Markelov, though, finds that shot with the Galil, and it's going to go 3-0 now as Flipside cement themselves a third round on the board.
That could have been great, though. The bomb was actually planted for him, so if he took out that second player without choking it, could have been absolutely massive. I think in that kind of situation, you usually want to go for the site player first before shooting that player up in the upper area, because, you know, you take the harder duel while they don't know you're there, and then you take the easier duel, especially when considering he was low HP. But jmqa wasn't to know that. But regardless, I was criticizing, of course, going for that force and them not having enough money to go into their buy. They finally do. The bomb plant going to be helping them quite a lot, and an unexpected bomb plant at that. So they will have the open L Patron, full nades as well, and all the armor they can wish for. But Flipside, as usual, going to be putting WorldEdit on the AWP of their own as he peeks up a bit aggressively towards a courtyard. Won't be catching anything off straight off the bat here, but just going to be holding things down with the smokes in play and the flashes from Blade as he goes for a little bit of information down and towards the lower here. Markelov gets tagged up there through the wall, but oh my god, facecrack. That's how you do it. Sprays into the smoke, drops Markelov over towards B, and now it's going to be a 5v4. Preparation finding their foot in the door, and they definitely need a round here on the board.
Yeah, I mean, foot in the door, foot through the door. What's the difference when you're Markelov? Are you just, not Markelov, sorry, he's the one who tasted the bullet. Face crack. What's the difference? Cracking faces is indeed his speciality. jmqa over towards B, trying to find these frags onto electronic, but he's going to be falling back. They don't want to give them more an advantage than they've already been able to yield, and the boost is going to come in through from WorldEdit. He finds that one in Arch. Now it's going to equalize things out 4-4, as well as that he legs Patron, and that's going to leave them with a HP advantage here. It started off looking very bad for Flipside, but they're using these boosts to devastating effect. Electric over towards B, Electronic, sorry, over towards B, trying to spot out this player. Oh. He finds out one of the facecrack bombs going to get dropped as well. Jmqa is going to be the one to try and trade this out. He's going to go aggressive in through long. Flash hits, but it's not going to hit him. And well, he does spot out those players, but doesn't find the frag just yet. 3-on-4 currently as they try to make their way in towards the B site. 30 seconds left, and the rotate's already underway from flip side here. WorldEdit is going to be up in heaven with that AWP in hand, and he's been wreaking some damage currently. Electronic's going to fall, so does Blade, but WorldEdit, he's not ready to go down just yet. Grabs himself two frags, got to find the third. He's going to go out with the USP. Comes in swinging as well, but Patron, it's just this little duel here, and while neither of them can land those shots, Patron just wants to save the AWP, though. 10 seconds left, not going to be enough time. Question is he going to get away with it?
Seems like he will. They aren't going to be chasing this one down. Not a lot of utility economy, sorry, on the CT side. And obviously, losing three rifle players in their buy round there means that they will have to start dropping some guns to the remaining players as well. So economy, as I said, not going to be the best. But they will be able to buy up here. CT side picking up four in a row now in preparation. They're left in that awkward situation where they don't know whether to buy up around the single saved rifle or if they just go for the eco and allow the Patron to do the entering and hopefully try and pick up rifles and work around that. They can go for a bit of a quasi, though, but actually instead just going to go for the full commitment here, full force. We've got a Galil, we've got a couple of Tet-9s, and we got a Deagle as well on Jmqa, but he's not going to be fully investing. Only going for a pistol and some armor. No nades on him, so preparation. They've gone for a bit of a force up here, and they will be just charging straight in towards the lower area. Blade, he's going to be holding things down alone. Bit of support over towards short, but he just goes straight in for the peak. Finds the first as well. There's still a smoke down in the way. Still goes to the second in Ubique. Trades things out here, so back into a more favorable position for preparation. They've grabbed themselves a useful rifle now, and that's going to be on Ubique as wayLander. He just holds across from Arch, waiting to see this push out of connector. And oh, Arch is going to catch out the arm of him, gets the damage off, but wayLander just re-peeks back in, not going to get punished there, takes the second kill, and that's going to be Ubique walking out as well. wayLander, he takes another, and now two players remain for preparation. Instantly just devastated there by the hold from Flipside, and it's going to be what looks like a lead to a 5-0 here for Flipside.
Yeah, but you can't count out preparation just yet. I mean, they might be able to find one frag in mid. Saying that, they don't have WorldEdit with the AWP in hand. He picks up one, wayLander's there to back him up, and well, actually, you know, I think you can count our preparation just yet, as Flipside get themselves a fifth round on the board. It's going to go 5-0, and it's been a very strong CT side start here. It's going to be into the sixth round now. Preparation, they're going to get another rifle buy on the cards. Plenty of utility as well to play around with. An Arch picking up the MAC-10. It's the MAC daddy of this round. I mean, he's a potential to farm some money with that, go aggressive early on. Wouldn't surprise me if we see him playing in towards connector for the close-up angles. And the question is, I mean, how do they deal with WorldEdit? He's been a force to be reckoned with that AWP so far, and he's been, you know, really putting into these points of contention. And as we head into this round, it looks to be no different. He's going to be playing aggressively pushed up in mid. Well, let's see if he can shut down this push before it even begins.
Yeah, and he will be holding the angle here. Patron ready to walk out, but again, they're going to be checking for the toilets push, and this time it's just out over and towards short, and WorldEdit going to get that first kill here as wayLander. He's going to be positioned to at least hold the toilets push from the preparation side, and he just backs off a little bit, holding a tight angle. Flash comes in, he peeks out of the way, but it still re-peeks over towards short as WorldEdit. He misses two shots there. This push still coming out from the prep side, and they're going to molly out of position. That is going to be wayLander having to go for the fight, and he will land it. Takes down facecrack. WorldEdit supports, and that's going to be the headshot onto Jmqa. Follows up as well, and Ubique goes down. Only going to be on Archer towards the long, but he is completely alone in this 1v5, and WorldEdit, he's just going to cement the round there for Flipside. Another headshot coming out from him. Massive AWP play indeed, and Flipside, that is going to be a 6-0, so pretty dominant here on their first map pick.
Yeah, no, I mean, they've started this off phenomenally. Preparation, they're going to be onto a force buy, presumably. They've got 3,600 kind of across the board. A few players who can buy, so it's actually just going to be a full-on kind of force up into this. Arch grabs himself an AK, Deagle for Patron, and then Facecrack with the Galil Tech-9s on the two remaining players. And the issue is, I mean, they're letting their economy get broken time and time again. They're just force buying up, and they've been struggling to do it with the rifles. Perhaps this change of pace in towards B might pay off, but Markelov's going to be there to answer back. Finds one with the AWP, and a Patron is going to go 4-on-5 as the push comes underway. And while they're making their way onto the site, lands a second as well. Blade's there to reinforce, makes it 3. And in comes Blade with two of his own. Markelov and Blade just cleaning up that B site.
Yeah, dynamic duo indeed. And we will see a pause called out here from preparation. Probably going to be the best thing to do in this kind of situation. Apparently, we've been told it is a tactical pause. So I really think I agree with that one. I don't think it takes anything special to agree. You know, a 7-0 scoreline, getting absolutely rinsed. And to be honest, I think the tactical pause is most going to be required for whoever isn't IGLing to turn to the IGL of preparation and go, maybe, just maybe, we should eco.
Yeah, no, I mean, that wouldn't surprise me if it's going something like that, Hugo, no. But maybe a little less British. But I mean, yeah, it hasn't been a very dominant performance from them early on. They've definitely seemed like the noticeably weaker side, as you can see by the 7-0 scoreline. As well as that, I mean, you've got Patron one frag, Arch on one frag. I mean, it's not very impressive here. I mean, when you look over towards Flipside, you got three players on 9 kills, and it's, you know, it is very much at the dismay of that preparation. I reckon during this, they're going to be having a very severe talk with the IGL. And, you know, I think this is a good example of when you should be using these tactical pauses. Normally, we see teams bringing them in a little bit too late on, but, I mean, you're only 7 rounds in. You've still got another 8 rounds left to play around with here. They can still come back and, you know, put up a fairly effective scoreline. So they haven't left it too late, and they've still got a lot of rounds left to play around with here. So I do think this is a great example, you know, and that is something preparation can at least say they are, a good example of when a team should be taking pauses and stuff like that.
Yeah, you know, just be a lesson for other teams, yeah, of course. Yeah. But the thing is, you can't bash on preparation too much for this scoreline, because obviously, as we said, while Flipside have made their own roster changes, moving Shara out and Electronic in, but that was only today, meaning, yeah, he may not be accompanied to his new role just yet. Preparation have made a complete team rehaul. Three players joining the roster, so that's going to be obviously Facecrack, Patron, and Ubique. So that's a bit of a switch up here. So you can't imagine Preparation are going to be as prepared. A bit ironically there against the Flipside team, but hopefully this pause won't be too long. We will be going back into the game shortly, but you can see they will be going for that buy, of course. Not able to get the bomb down, but the loss bonus is going to be favouring them, as well as the saved economy from previous rounds. They're going to be getting some AKs, a bit of armour, and some nades as well to bat. Patron on the AWP, and we have seen this double AWP play here from Flipside. We obviously saw WorldEdit and Markelov both stepping up in the previous rounds on the AWP, and Markelov obviously being quite famous for using the AWP, at least in older iterations of CS, whereas WorldEdit recently just, well, not recently, but in terms of CSGO being an absolutely huge AWP for Flipside and proving to be amazing on LAN and online as well. So pretty unstoppable duo here from the Flipside team.
Yeah, definitely. While we are in a little break, what do you think of the player Arch on preparation? Not in terms of his skill, but just for his name. I love it when players call themselves after calls, because I think it makes it a caster's nightmare. You know, if you could imagine you had a team just full of, like, one guy called mid, one guy called long, you know, Arch as well playing the rifle role. I feel like that would be a fairly good team comp. But, yeah, no, hopefully the... there we go. The pause actually be called out of effect now, and it's going to be going underway as we approach round 8. As you can see, it's a fairly formidable buy on the side of preparation. You've got the AWP on Patron. They are a little bit lackluster in terms of their utility. And, well, hopefully they can make up for that in their newfound tactical prowess and fragging power. But, you know, that's all gonna be hopefully evident into this 8th round.
Yeah, we'll see how it comes into fruition for them, of course. And a bit of B control is going to be the name of the game for this one. Nothing too aggressive, but they are just going to be holding the outside of A. That's going to be a face crack there, just waiting for the push, of course. And he's going to be over in Connector, maybe coming up into a fight with Blade, who's going to be holding down Connector, as he has been doing very well so far. But Markelov just pushing out into short. The lack of control here from preparation going to be apparent, and finding that first pick. So dropping Ubique, won't be able to spot the bomb, but that's a bit more information for Flipside to work off. And even if it's not even that, they have got the man advantage, which is huge for the CT side. And it's not like they need it being 7-0 up. So we'll see how it comes out for prep.
Yeah, they are going to go on one-man disadvantage very early on, like you're saying. It's something that we've seen time and time again. It allows Flipside just to trade evenly into the rounds, and then they come into it very favorably. Preparation, they're really struggling at coming back from this. There was their opportunity as wayLander goes aggressive in towards long, and they might punish him for it as they go and meet his aggression with, you know, some of their own. Opting out to take mid-control. Facecrack's going to be the one to peek it in from a party, trying to get the information here. Patron as well with the AWP in hand to trade for him if it comes down to it. But, I mean, they do manage to get mid relatively uncontested. Wayliner's going to go a little bit aggressive over towards A once again, play up near the cubby by toilets. And they do also keep Arch, as per usual, down towards B to watch for any rotators here, try to grab some information and, you know, make sure no one from Flipside's getting a little bit too aggressive.
Yeah, now we will see potentially a bit of a push. There's only 20 seconds remain on the clock here. The bomb actually rotating down connected, but we still got two players. Now make that only one. Facecrack going to be pushing up alone over towards the A site to create a bit of distraction. We will see the rotations come in here as Markov, he holds down the line from the site, drops the first. That's a bomb out of the hands of preparation. And with only 8 seconds left, what the hell are you supposed to do in that situation? It's a 3v4. Patron comes back in with a kill, but they only just get this bomb plant down. Blade going to be trying to deny it, running in towards the site, and will drop Patron, but the bomb, it has been planted. Well, Facecrack has a great position to do some punishment here. The bomb's not going to be planted for him, so he drops the first. That's WorldEdit going down, but they still got to worry about this imminent defuse that's going to come in. Facecrack, he takes a second, but wayLander, he's going to be sticking the bomb here, and he's going to get away with it. Flipside, that will be 8-0, and the closest round here for prep, but still not going to go in their way. Flipside, another dominant lead here, but they do lose all the players at the end of the day, so having to rebuy and spend a bit more of their CTO economy.
Yeah, I mean, that did look a lot better, though, from preparation. I think we can both agree on that. They got the bomb down. They actually managed to kill every member of Flipside as well in the progress. And, you know, that was a fairly nice change from them. And hopefully that pause has come into effect. As we already see in that round, they've you know, almost done infinitely better than what they were doing previously. WorldEdit, though, is going to go aggressive out in towards mid, playing up by Party here as he gets boosted on over and, well, might be able to find one frag on Arch as he goes out onto Park. Isn't able to land that shot, though, and does give up mid as a result, looking to fall on back. Waylander's playing aggressively in from toilets, and the crossfire is going to be coming on through in the form of him and WorldEdit as they look to take a rather aggressive stance here in mid and long.
Yeah, but the thing is, despite that round being so close for preparation, I still feel like it was so rushed, the last second push coming in, and they had to rely on those aim duels. If they lost them, that was going to be the round over. So it's such a, you can't base a strategy just off getting frags in a site with 15 seconds left. But still, it goes away of preparation. Oh, sorry, Flipside, and you can see this round looking like it's going the way of Flipside as well. Waylander aggression over towards long, as he does in the previous rounds, drops Arch straight away. But we may have a player catching off as they try and back off in towards the toilets. But Facecrack, he's just going to get eliminated. His own face getting cracked. Cracked in by Waylander's bullets, and again, Flipside, another pick here. I mean, what do you even say about this? There's nothing that preparation can do in this kind of situation. And now we will see a couple of the players pushing up towards the B site. The bomb joining them as well, and jmqa entering his patron. He attempts to do some work, but the flash is going to come in.
Yeah, the utility being used to keep them off the site phenomenally well here from Flipside. Electronic's going to be able to find one. Patron does get find that return frag. It's going to go 2-on-3 now, but WorldEdit in from heaven picks that one up, and with only 30 seconds left, Ubique's got to try and make this one work. Lots of ground to cover, though. He's able to pick up one frag on a blade. It's going to go 1-on-2, and Waylander's down to 4 HP, so potentially he could make his way back into this round, but then WorldEdit is just going to be too strong with that pistol. It gets taken down 8 HP. Ubique, if you just, you just did 8 HP more, maybe try a little bit harder next time. It's going to go 9-0 as Flipside. Well, they're taking a very, very dominant first half. Preparation, showing perhaps that maybe they weren't that prepared going into this game, are going to be a 9 disadvantage to their opponents here. And while they are buying back up into this round, forces upon forces here. They have a fairly strong economy this time around, but two Galils in the hands of Arch and jmqa, and very little utility once again. I mean, we can note that they've barely had a full set of utility into any of these rounds so far.
I honestly feel like they've only had two full buy rounds.
Yeah.
And those are rounds that they got the bomb down prior to, so able to get that extra money allowing them to buy the utility as well as the AWP patron. But oh my god, I mean... What? Markelov flicks onto jmqa, receives the dink as well, so it's still a bit of damage done for the preparation side. But I mean, if you're gonna have a low HP player, it's better to have them on an AWP than a rifle. So not too much of a loss here for Flipside, and they still have that extra man advantage. But I mean, preparation, just not able to get their foot in the door. And while Facecrack, he may be pushed up a little bit aggressively here over towards toilets, Waylander seems like he may be able to catch him out as he starts to push up himself. But actually, just holding off towards long, he should hear these footsteps shortly as the rest of the prep players, they start to join him and push up. A WorldEdit, got to be the man to take this fight as Ubique. He may just walk into the shot. This is just so, so close. So WorldEdit pushed up, Waylander pushed up, and WorldEdit finally going to decide to back off, it seems. But Facecrack, he's going to be holding the exit here, so it could come into a bit of a dangerous territory. Blade supporting him, though, both pushing around at the same time, and Facecrack, he's not able to get anything and not expecting that push. And Patron will return as well as Ubique, and now it's suddenly going to be a 3v2 as WorldEdit over on the site does some damage. Trade out again, and Markelov is extremely low, meaning in preparation. They may have a chance to pick up this round, but backing off is going to be bad timing because Electronic, he's going to hear it, is ready for this one, drops Patron, and just backing off, putting it into a 2v2 one and leaving the time too low for Arch, really, as we see Markelov rotate back in towards 8.
Yeah, Markelov, though, only on 2 HP, does have the AWP, and he's been a force to be reckoned with so far. Arch just missing that shot, but he's going to focus on getting the bomb down. Rotates coming in the form of Electronic, who flanked all the way down through B. Is he going to be approaching from the same side? Does Arch know this? He's going to hear him out on the rotate, so potentially yes. And now he's got to try and hold this down. Bomb is planted, though, and he's 1v2. Markelov as well is very low HP, and he's going to get taken down. Now it's going to go 1-on-1. He goes aggressive, but there's Electronic with that shot. And that's going to mop up the 10th round on the board. His flip side make their way into double digits very, very triumphantly here. But once again, a very close round, actually, from preparation. They do a good bit of damage. It's just the issue is, at this point, they need to be doing more than economic damage. They need to be getting rounds on the board.
No reason to jump spot after finding that kill from Markelov. Just trying to jump spot over the site to catch out their last remaining player here, Electronic. And obviously, he just gets headshot at the server. So unlucky there for preparation once again. A round for Flipside. They've secured double digits, as we said. So still plenty of economy on the CT side. Nothing to be worried about, of course. And preparation finally actually going to be able to get a full buy up. A proper full buy with utility. Sadly, not the AWP and Patron, but we still got the AKs and a couple of Molotovs as well to work with. So not as bad as we have been seeing, at least in the previous rounds. But it's all going to come down to whether they can actually string together the kills to secure a round for themselves. And, I mean, judging by previous performance, doesn't seem to be realistic here. Electronic just going to be silenced in the first as he pushes out over towards B monster, dropping jmqa, support from Markelov as well, and he's going to drop another. Arch gets completely taken out there, and preparation again in a two-man deficit, and it may just make it three. That's going to be WorldEdit over towards short.
Yeah, Ubique gets to go aggressive through the smoke, but Electronic's going to find him. It's going to go 2-on-5 now as Patron and Facecrack might be the remaining players left alive for preparation, trying to make something happen over towards A. They find good damage on a WorldEdit, but not enough to kill him. They do hit him down in 10 HP in the process. And now Facecrack making his way back through T spawn, trying to grab that bomb. Looking like he's going to be heading down over towards B. And as Patron gets taken down at 8 HP and they fake a rotate over towards the A site, it wouldn't be too much of a bad idea. Electronic is going to fall as he goes aggressive in towards B as well. Now it's going to go 3-on-2, and preparation suddenly looking like they might be able to find some sort of way back into this round. 45 seconds left on that clock. Good bit of time left to play around with here. And Facecrack slowly but surely, and most importantly, quietly making his way in towards this B site. Only Markelov to hold this one down. The issue is, you say only Markelov, but
it's not only.
Yeah,
is it?
It's not only. Patron, though, on the other hand, doing some work over towards A, finds one on the blade, puts it into this 2v2, and now Markelov actually has to rotate on up. They can't chance it. Only 20 seconds left. Patron doing a very good job of lurking this one out. It's going to get taken out by WorldEdit, and now it's all going to be on Facecrack. 1v2 with bomb planted on that B site.
But the plant's so open here, it's going to allow him to sneak in towards the CT spawn. And if he goes back into upper after finding this original pick, he may be able to just hold the bomb down there from that position. So a really good bomb plant position from him. Markelov might check the corner, though, and he will. Still gets taken down. Facecrack, he finds the shot off, and now WorldEdit with only 10 HP. The man to step up here for Flipsid3, but he's not going to be able to do it. Dominance there from Facecrack. Nice, aggressive afterplant and preparation. They will finally secure that first round. If that bomb plant wasn't allowed to be so open there from Prep, they may not have had such an aggressive afterplant over towards the CT spawn. But still, regardless, it does happen, and a 10-1 scoreline. And this is just the epitome of the CT economy here. Flipsid3, they win 10 rounds in a row, and they have to eco after losing one. Obviously, the reason for this being is preparations seem to be doing damage in the rounds that are losing, meaning Flipsid3 have to constantly invest in buying up new rifles, and that's the reason that Flipsid3 are clearly struggling, at least in terms of economy. But they will be obviously going for only a single eco, you can only imagine.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, preparations economy, they win that round. It doesn't look that much better. I mean, they've got two Galils once again, and only a little bit of utility to go into this round with. Flipsid3 can still be extremely dangerous on these pistol buys, and they are very much bearing that in mind, as you can tell by the buy they've got on the cards. We're going to be seeing two players going aggressive towards long, with Patron as well watching out towards B. He finds one on a blade. That's going to give them the one-man advantage early on. And, well, over towards long, wayLander, he's pushed up very aggressively here. Arch is going to be the one to try and check this corner. Does spot him out, and he's going to get taken down. And now that's two players at the advantage of preparation. Arch as well makes it a second in towards long, finds one on the world, and it's going to put it into a 2v5 now for the remaining members of Flipsid3. Markelov with the deagle and armor, and Electronic with a P250 pushing out together. Brothers in arms here, but jmqa trying to step up to the plate. It's going to find a little bit of damage, goes to the spray down, and he gets them both. There we go. That's what they needed. A quick, clean, and concise round where they don't lose anyone just to build up that economy that much more.
Yep, going to be so apparent here in the later rounds of this half. Obviously, three more to go, so preparation's only chance to at least have some kind of revenge on towards the Flipsid3 team, and it is going to be their chance to at least put it up to 5-10. And obviously, Flipsid3 going to do their best to disallow that. Markelov, they're going to be only on a pistol in this round, as we do see WorldEdit taking the AWP for the CT side. Still the better player to give the AWP to, and we do have rifles on the rest of the players as well, aside from Markelov. So not too bad of a buy. Obviously, they don't want to start ecoing so many rounds when they are up against what you could, I guess you could argue is a lesser team, especially less prepared team, ironically. So going for that force, of course, and a fairly decent one will come of it. Preparation, though, they are going to be heading for what looks like a fast B rush here, and Markelov going to be the man to try and hold things down, but with only a pistol, it's not going to be a great situation. Still drops the first, so now it's going to be a 1-for-1 trade as Ubique goes down, but Ubique, sorry, takes down Electronic, but we will still see two more kills going in the favor of Prep, finally putting it into a really viable situation for them, as Flipsid3 is just left with two more retaking CTs, WorldEdit and wayLander, and to be honest, I think the save is going to be coming in here.
Yeah, a lot of it relied on wayLander finding that frag there, and well, he's actually going to complete the transition from entry frag to entry frag. As he falls, it's going to go 1-on-5 now. WorldEdit, AWP in hand, a little bit of utility to his name. He's going to want to save this one out, take it into the 14th round and see what they can do. The economy on Flipsid3 isn't really going to support buying up into the next round. They might be tempted to force behind the AWP, see if they can make anything happen on the back of that. But I mean, then if they lose it, they are going to be faced with the eco for the last round, well, you know, for the force buy. So, you know, it might just be all down to WorldEdit. Try and make something happen in this round. Just go huge with the AWP, while the rest of his team stick with those vanilla pistols. Scoreline's going to go 10-3. And preparation suddenly looking almost like a bit of a different team since that pause earlier.
Yeah, definitely so. And you've got to see if they can pick it up for the last couple of rounds. Obviously, a 5-10 half on Overpass isn't that bad on the T side, considering you're an underdog team. And of course, there is potential for them to actually maybe even take a win if they secure the pistol. But it is all going to be depending on that pistol. But let's not jump the gun. Let's just stay in this first half here. As Flipsid3, they do go for that buy, or that eco, sorry, not deciding to buy around the AWP of WorldEdit. We've got a deagle and a few P250s and a couple of flashbangs to get themselves in a pushed up aggressive position here on the CT side. And preparation, again, just going to be holding for said aggression, but finally making a decision they want to push him towards B. And well, he has to step up here. He is the only man with the AWP, and he does take the first one down. Arch going to get dropped. That's a rifle player out of the hands of the T side. Sorry, and he peeks in again for a second, drops JMQA, and he's going to try and follow up. But he's got these aggressive CT players over towards short, denying preparation any entry on towards the B site. And this is just such a great setup for Flipside. The stack over towards B working out massively.
Yeah, we said they needed WorldEdit to go huge into this round, and well, huge he does go as he picks up those two frags over towards B. It's going to yield them two weapons as well. Actually, only one, as I believe Ubique or Facecrack picks up one of the AKs, steals it away. But you know, they do manage to get an AK up on Electronic as well as the Molotov, and now they rotate players up in towards A site. Ubique's going to be the one to try and challenge. WorldEdit's there, though, with the AWP in hand, and he's been like a brick wall currently to preparation. They've had a very hard job of trying to find the frag. Wayland's going to get spotted out by UB because he just pops his little mushroom cap thing over the top of the SWAT van. Ubique making his way out, though, swiftly and silently. He might be able to find one in a WorldEdit. He's trying to play around the truck here with the AWP out. And down in towards B, on the other hand, Patron. He's going to be playing the lurk role. He gets dropped, and Wayland is just going to be remaining up on towards the A site. That's going to be very bad for Facecrack here, as he does have the bomb. He's got a little bit of time left as well. Might be able to find this frag and potentially the bomb plant, which you know, is the best of a worst-case scenario here for preparation.
Yep, should be the round for Flipside once again here, and actually bringing it off of, well, I guess you could say Eco, as long as you don't count the saving player onto WorldEdit. So great round for them, and obviously the time going to be too low here to really commit to a bomb plant when the Molotov is down on the site. He has to go for the truck plant, and that's going to allow Electronic to just slide on in there. All lubed up. He takes down Facecrack, and Flipside, they will take an 11-3 scoreline here.
Yeah, no, 11-3, like you say. Flipside, they win a round that they really shouldn't have won. WorldEdit picking up two huge frags there to start things off, and well, then the rest of it just fell into place for Flipside. Preparation might take a little bit of a notch out of the momentum as well. I mean, we saw them building up a lot of pace, a lot of aggression into this, as they did take those three consecutively off of Flipside, and now it's going to be the last round of the half, 11-4, and they need to really, 11-3, sorry, they need to pick up a fourth round, or else they are in danger of seeing Flipside win a one pistol, and then at that point, if they convert the rest of the rounds, they can easily take this to match point.
Yeah, and that's not going to be good. Preparation, they want as big as a buffer as they can take, and of course, if they take four, as you said, losing the pistol isn't going to be as bad. Still going to be pretty dire, but it's not going to be the complete loss that we will be expecting here. So, of course, the 4v4 going to be in play. Flipside able to trade out of that original kill found onto Markelov, taking down Facecrack, and of course, we will just see them back off here, but the advantage is just still going to be in the favor of Prep, because they do have the not only the most utility here on each side, but they also have the 4v4, and that's going to favor the Ts, because it means the CTs have to split out more towards certain sites, and stacking less players towards each site means it's going to be easier for the Ts to at least converge on if they go for a full rush. But right now, talking about split, the Ts are split themselves. Couple over towards Connector, and that Molotov may just force these players out of position. Patron, he has to peek up towards the stairs, but luckily for him, there's going to be no Flipside players just lurking in the dark. So we do see a very slow round for Flipside. Well done in position to get a kill, or at least a pick, but he's got to worry about his B short as well.
Yeah, and well, as Arch tries to make his way back to grab that bomb, was in danger of being picked up by Waylander, but it's not going to come into fruition. Well, then in towards B, primed and ready to find that frag on a Patron. That's going to yield him the one-man advantage as he falls back looking to keep that. He's actually going to go aggressive trying to spot out Ubique, but not going to yield anything, seeing as you know, not going to be landing any crazy jump shots just yet. Bombs rotated in towards B, and with 20 seconds left, they're going to have to commit to this play. Flashes are going to go out. Well, then it's got the AWP in hand. Going to miss that first shot. Ubique in from short might be the one to get the return frag here as he goes aggressive, finds that shot, and well, Electronic's going to be there. Does manage to pick up two frags on a Ubique and Arch, respectively. Now it's all going to be on jmqa. One versus two, and Waylander in from short finds the frag. And just like that, it's going to go 12-3. A very, very strong first half, sorry, from Flipside.
Definitely. So nothing really shown from preparation that's too dominant, of course. Only managing to pick up those three rounds in the very late halves, very late rounds of the half. And that's going to put them in a real deficit here. If they lose a pistol, it's pretty much GG. Because, of course, assuming Flipside, they pick up their anti-ecos respectively, they should be taking the 15-3 scoreline. And I mean, really, I've not got too much hope for preparation in this kind of situation. You can always say, oh, the game's not over till it's over, there's always time for a comeback, but I think in this kind of situation it should be done and dusted here for Flipside, and the pistol is only going to at least enhance the last few rounds of preparation they're able to pick up before Flipside just slam the door shut on their hand.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's not looking that good for them, is it? They've got very little margin for error here on the pistol round, and preparation of showing that they're huge fans of error throughout playing tonight. And, well, 12-3 as we head into the first pistol round of the second half. First and only.
Only pistol round.
But, yeah, I mean, we are going to be seeing a fairly aggressive buy coming out from Flipside. They have Blade as well, who's got the smokes and flashes for them. A little bit of utility to get them out of the site. Over on preparation side, Ubique onto the defuse kit. Everyone else with you know, armor. It's a fairly standard buy. Patron going to be trying to find some damage early on in mid, and then they send Facecrack backed up, of course, by his compadre Arch in towards Connector to try and find these frags early on, and currently it's working. They get one on a Waylander, but Electronic equalizes things out by finding one on a Ubique on the other side of the map. Markelov just escapes with his life intact, 36 HP, and now he's going to move into an advantageous position. Finds one, goes for the spray as well, still alive and kicking, 20 HP left. Blade comes in to reinforce, and well, in the blink of an eye, Arch finds himself stuck between a rock and a hard place. He gets taken down, and now it's all on Patron. He's managed to get himself in a really good position in the back lines here, but he's got four members of Flipside left to find.
And really no potential to do so. Markelov grabs himself a USP, Electronic on that PT-50, of course, and the bomb going down towards the site. Flipside, they are going to put that nail in the coffin here for Patron. While he may have the element surprise onto one of these players, WorldEdit not even going to get a drop on him to at least secure a more doable round. Finally does find the headshot, but it's still going to be a 1v3. And Flipside, they don't even have to take these fights. They will, though. Patron finds two, and Electronic still on top of the box here. He has to hit this headshot, gets Stink down to 5 HP, and you can see Flipside just holding back here. They don't have to take any more engagements, and Patron surely won't be able to do this. Electronic going to be able to deny it. And Flipside, they will take their 13-3 scoreline here. Pretty much done and dusted now as they secure the pistol round and pretty much take their second two rounds by default as well.
Yeah, and you know, Flipside, they're not showing a lot of respect. You've got the two MAC-10s, which does show they're pretty confident in this. I'm hoping Waylander goes for something a little bit more risky, but he goes for the UMP. Would have liked to have seen a sawn off, but you know, we're not going to be seeing that anytime soon. They've got two AKs as well on WorldEdit and Electronic for the long-range superiority, and it's going to be a force buy coming out from preparation, as you would expect. And, well, Patron's going to get tagged down early on. He's going to be dropped by Waylander with the UMP. Scout losing to an SMG. A little bit embarrassing, but we're not going to say anything about that. Markelov is going to fall, though, as Facecrack picks him up. And now it's going to go 4-4. They equalize things on out. And as a result, they do manage to clear out Connector as well. So they've been able to take a decent portion of map control. They're going to relinquish it by falling back onto these sites. And as a result, Flipside, they've got a lot of room to maneuver here. They've got control of mid. They think they've got control of Connector. They are going to have to split out onto that. WorldEdit, of course, he is aware that his comrade Markelov died down there. Rest in peace. And, you know, they'll be going in to try and clear that out together. Waylander to back him up. But they've got a minute left on the clock. Plenty of time left to play around with here. Good bit of utility as well. And they have the firepower advantage.
Yep. Rest in peace. Markelov glocks out everyone as we do see Flipside start to initiate their push over towards the A side, but at the same time, preparation, it's like their T side. I don't think they realize they switch over to CT because they're going to be pushing themselves, not towards Connector, though, this time over towards the courtyard. And Blade, he's going to be able to catch out that first player. Spots Ubique, the push coming in here. He has a nade to work with, throws that out as well. Could do some good damage, but the MAC-10 instead going to be doing the damage that I mentioned. Ubique going down. Arch does follow up with the scout on Facecrack, also dropping Blade. So suddenly, this is looking a little more bright for preparation, but Electronic just going to be able to execute jmqa as he pushes out of the Connector door. And now two players remain here for prep. Not a great situation. Electronic finds another, and now it's all going to be on Facecrack alone over towards the Connector. Has to hit this first shot, but not going to be checking his flank. WorldEdit just holding the angle there towards the bomb. And Flipside, they are going to be taking the 14-3 now, so almost full eco from preparation. You can see a pause is going to be called out. Quite interesting. I'm not too sure why you'd really call a pause of 14-3.
Is it a tilt pause? I'm almost certain it's a preparation pause. I can't imagine Flipside are really having to sit down and think about the. Really?
Okay.
I thought it's a tactical. It's a Flipside technical. I thought it was tactical. I was going to say, why would they be taking a tactical pause? What would they possibly be talking through at this point?
There was that famous case. A tilt pause was called in. I think it was Astralis, or maybe it was Astralis versus the old Fnatic. So pre-Godsent's lineup. So it was, you know, obviously the old Fnatic with Olaf without Pronax, and Astralis. Fnatic apparently was smack-talking Astralis before the match on the LAN, saying, oh, it's going to be an easy game. Astralis whooped them, pulled it like a 16-1, and on the 15-1 or whatever it was, they called a pause just to tilt the opponents, just to kind of say, and Carrigan gave this interview afterwards talking about, you know, it's just to show that we're something to be messed with. You shouldn't get so confident up against us. And Fnatic apparently weren't too happy about that, obviously. But I was thinking as I heard Flipside pause, maybe they're just tilting preparation. Maybe there's some arguments going on. But no, a technical pause, and we'll be back into the game now. So no more delays here as we do see this push on towards the B site. And that's going to be Electronic trying to take the fight here as he spots out jmqa just over the top of the smoke, but moving out of position. Again, preparation going to be forcing the issue here, so going for the pistol armor. They had 1900 loss bonus, and that's pretty much it here. They've got a bit of utility as well on some of the players, but by and large, nothing too special for preparation. And Flipside, they should be able to dispatch these players one by one.
Yeah, and well, Jibica's going to be the first to fall, and that's going to give them the one-man advantage. Ube is going to be there to get the return frag onto Electronic, and it's going to go 4-on-4 here, but with the aggressive play coming in from a preparation in through Connector, I'm going to yield them some frags. Wayland's here to watch it out, and he finds the first. Ubeek as well on towards the B site. It's going to get taken down, and now it's all going to fall onto Patron here, 1 versus 4. He's got a lot of work to do. Not a lot of time, not a lot of anything, really. He has got a Deagle to try and make it work, and perhaps we could be seeing a little bit of Deagle magic today. Would you say the odds of that are very high, Hugo?
No, absolutely not.
Oh, okay.
Not.
Well, then, you know, I'm a believing man myself.
Every 1D he gets, we hear a little ring of the bell. There we go.
I'm putting the bell away. We don't need to see this ever again. It's being retired. Bell is gone. It's out. 15-3 is the scoreline now. And flip side, extremely dominant here. Preparation, they never even so much as got their foot in the door, really.
No, not... You don't even need to analyze this.
Yeah, no, you don't.
No, that's it. There
it
we
doesn't
go.
Take anyone really, anyone, any, you know, mastermind to work out what's happened here. And, well, they are going to be force buying up into what is probably the last round here for them. They are going to make something happen with the Deagles and the 5-7s. And Patron does have that scout, but he's been fairly not, you know, not too impactful with it in these force buys.
Or at all.
Oh, okay. Shots fired. Waylander, though, might be looking for a little bit of a spray here, but Arch instead steals his thunder, finds two with the UMP. They're going to keep up the aggression, though, and Blade's able to get a return. Markelov as well, watching Connect, is able to get one on a Patron. Now it's going to go 2-on-2 as Preparation actually trading fairly favorably into the early engagements there. Facecrack's going to be going aggressively in from behind. WorldEdit is able to find one onto jmqa, and Facecrack does all he can. He takes down one, puts it into a 1 versus 1 now, but it is the story of David versus Goliath here. I mean, Facecrack is very much... Facecrack is very much David, and well, that it's very much Goliath. Apart from in this story, David just gets annihilated.
Yeah, and shot in the face by WorldEdit.
Yeah.
So there you go. But I mean, what a dominant map there, really. 16-3 in the first one of this best of two, of course, between a Preparation and Flipside. Now, Reen, usually we typically go into analysis, discuss what went wrong, talk about it, but I just feel like it's just. Let's not waste our time. Let's not waste a viewer's time. There's no analysis here. Yeah, 16-3. Anything to say?
Not really. A very dominant performance from Flipside. On the other hand, they just didn't show up on the side of Preparation. It just wasn't there. The Preparation wasn't there at that. And so it's going to be 16-3 to finish things off. We'll be live with Map 2 very shortly, I think, and we're going to go to some commercials for the time being.
We will. See you in a minute.